Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture on triglycerides. In this video I am going to explain what are triglycerides and their chemical properties, like rancidity, which is caused by oxidation of triglycerides, and trans fats, which are formed due to partial hydrogenation of triglycerides, and finally saponification, which is a process of soap formation. Now this is my channel. You just type in my name, G. Sai Rajesh, in YouTube, you will get the channel. I have 1840 subscribers and 120 videos related to pharma lectures. If you like the video, do subscribe. Get into the class. Now, see, triacylglycerols, triglycerides, fats, neutral fats, all of them are synonyms. They are used interchangeably. All of them are same. Triglycerides are also known as fats, neutral fats, and triacylglycerols. Now, when you see them, these triacylglycerols are esters of fatty acid and glycerol. Esters are made by the combination of alcohol and acids. Now in this case the acid is fatty acid, whereas the alcohol is glycerol. Now glycerol has got three hydroxy groups, so all the three hydroxy groups can combine with three of the fatty acids. Because they are combining with three fatty acids, they have got this name, triglycerides. So this is what is known as triacylglycerols or triglycerides. Now you need to understand the difference between fat and oil. Fat, a triglycerides, that is solid at room temperature, whereas oil is also a triglyceride, which is liquid at room temperature. Now understand the differences between fat and fatty acid. See, fat is an ester. That ester is formed due to the combination of acid and alcohol, and this acid part is known as fatty acid. So both of them are different. Fat is an ester, whereas fatty acid is an acid part of the fat. Moving further, now see, triglycerides, as we have seen, they are formed due to the combination of an alcohol and acid. In this case the alcohol is glycerol. Glycerol, as I told you, is made up of three hydroxy group, which is also known as a triol. Tri means three, ol means alcoholic groups. Now all the three alcoholic groups can combine with three of the fatty acids. It could be the same or it could be mixed fatty acids. Most of the time it is mixed fatty acids which are found in all the natural lipids. Now so see, from this acid and from this alcohol, a water molecule is lost and an ester bond formation occurs. So by losing three of the water molecules, it forms a triglyceride. So this is how triglycerides are formed. Now this is again the depiction of triglycerides. So it has got this alcohol as glycerol residue and then three of the fatty acid residues. The same thing is depicted here. Now let us see the importance of triglycerides in animals, which includes human beings. They are the major energy storage forms. The reason is, see, triglycerides, when you look at this picture, triglycerides, when they undergo hydrolysis, they will be releasing these fatty acids. Now the released fatty acids are not esterified, hence they are also known as free fatty acids. Now these free fatty acids will undergo oxidation process known as beta oxidation, and that beta oxidation results in acetyl CoAs, and these acetyl CoAs will get into citric acid cycle. ATP will be produced. Excuse me. So these triglycerides serves as major energy storage and they produce lot of ATP, and also they are releasing fatty acids for the production of other lipids. All of them are because of hydrolysis of this bond and releasing these free fatty acids. The other fact, free fatty acids are in highest reduced form. Reduced form means the free fatty acid contain hydrocarbons which has got lot of hydrogens. So when they undergo oxidation, they forms many number of ATPs. So that is the reason why lipids give lot of energy when compared to carbohydrates. Almost twice energy is provided by the lipids when compared to carbohydrates, and they also act as insulation, thermal control. Now coming to the chemical properties, triglycerides has got three major chemical properties are there. One, oxidation. So triglycerides in presence of oxygen undergoes oxidation and results in small organic molecules. The second one is known as hydrogenation, catalytic hydrogenation. Hydrogenation means addition of this hydrogen. So what happens is, when the unsaturated triglycerides will add up hydrogen and results in saturated triglycerides. So the double bonds which is present in carbon and carbon will take hydrogens and convert it into saturated triglycerides. So this is called hydrogenation. Now the last one, saponification, is the formation of soap. Reaction of triglyceride with hydroxide ion results in the formation of soap. All the industrially produced soaps are because of this process called as saponification. Let us see them one by one. The first one, oxidation, triglyceride oxidation, it causes a condition called as rancidity. Let us understand this. When lipid-rich foods are exposed to atmospheric air, which contains oxygen, oxidative cleavage of double bonds in unsaturated fatty acids occurs. So the double bonds will undergo oxidative cleavage. They will be cleaved in presence of oxygen, hence it is known as oxidative cleavage. It results in the formation of aldehydes and carboxylic acids of shorter chain. Because they are in shorter chain, they have high volatility is there. Because of their high volatility, they will immediately give a smell. The taste and smell is unpleasant. So the formation of shorter chain volatile unpleasant organic molecule is called as rancidity. Rancidity is because of this. When lipid is exposed to atmospheric oxygen for a long time, oxidative cleavage of unsaturated fatty acid results in the formation of aldehydes and carboxylic acid, and that gives an unpleasant smell. So this process is called as rancidity. In fact, to be precise, it is called as oxidative rancidity because it is happening in presence of oxygen. Let us see the details. See, this is a typical triglyceride, wherein you have this glycerol is there, which is combined with three of the different fatty acids. Now, in this fatty acids, look at this. This unsaturated bond undergoes cleavage and results in aldehyde. This one also undergoes oxidative cleavage, results in aldehyde, and the other one results in the formation of carboxylic acids. This is what is known as oxidative rancidity. The unsaturated bonds in presence of oxygen undergoes cleavage and results in the formation of aldehyde and carboxylic acids. This is called as oxidative rancidity. Now, when you see, you have another kind of rancidity is also there. It is known as hydrolytic rancidity. Hydrolytic rancidity means breaking the triglyceride into fatty acid and glycerol. Most of the time it occurs in presence of enzymes like lipase. Lipase are the enzymes which will break down lipids and moisture. So we have broadly two kinds of rancidity is there. One hydrolytic, second one is oxidative. Oxidative we have seen, it occurs in the presence of atmospheric oxygen, wherein a C double bond C undergoes cleavage, and this is catalyzed by light, heat, oxygen and trace metals. Hydrolytic is breakdown of free fatty acids and glycerol. It will not form aldehydes or acids, and it is mostly catalyzed by enzymes like lipases. Now this is a major problem for all the commercial food products. So to avoid this, antioxidants are used. So these are the substances which can prevent oxidative rancidity, and they are known as antioxidant. Anti means they are stopping oxidation, hence they are known as antioxidants, like tocopherols, vitamin E, gallic acid and alpha naphthol are added to commercial preparations to prevent rancidity. So we have three of them are there, tocopherols, gallic acid and alpha naphthol. They are added to commercial preparations, whereas for foods there are propylgallate, butylated hydroxyanisole and butylated hydroxytoluene are used as antioxidants. So propylgallate, butylated hydroxyanisole and butylated hydroxytoluene. They are food preservatives, whereas commercial preservatives or antioxidants are tocopherol, alpha naphthol and gallic acid. So their job is to prevent oxidative rancidity. So this is about oxidation of triglycerides and rancidity. Moving further, now the next process is catalytic hydrogenation, which is also known as partial hydrogenation. Now, just now we have seen the C double bond C is what is causing rancidity. So if there is more unsaturation, there is a more chance for rancidity. So commercial oil producers will try to reduce the number of unsaturation. So they do it by hydrogenation. See, all these triglycerides, the natural triglycerides has got cis configuration unsaturated bond. So all these are in one side, and that is called a cis configuration. Now during this catalytic hydrogenations, it is not possible to convert all the double bonds into single bonds. What happens is it occurs only partial hydrogenation. That means only some of the double bonds are converted into single bonds. So that process is called as partial hydrogenations. But the undesirable effect is the cis bonds are converted into trans bonds. You can see the opposite sides, opposite groups are there around this double bond. So they are known as trans fats. Trans fats are formed because of this catalytic hydrogenation. Now there is a problem with trans fats. Now trans fats, they increase LDL and they reduce HDL. LDL is known as bad cholesterol, low density lipoprotein, whereas HDL is known as good cholesterol. So for cardiovascular health, these are dangerous things. So always make sure that there are low amounts of trans fats in lipid preparations. And trans fats are due to partial hydrogenation of commercial oils. So the third process, saponification, which is also known as soap formation. Now how does it form? A triglyceride is taken and it is treated with an alkali in presence of heat. That results in three long chain carboxylate ion formation and then glycerol. Now this is what is known as a soap. To get the details, look at this. An acid, which is nothing but an oil, which because it contains fatty acids, is treated with a base and it results in the formation of soap. Triacyl glycerol, sodium hydroxide, heat and water results in glycerol, salts of carboxylic acid. Now how it is acting as soap, let us see them. See, this long chain fatty acid, it has got a carboxylic acid. That part acts as a polar head. The remaining hydrocarbon chain acts as non-polar trail. All the textbooks depict the same thing. This is a non-polar hydrocarbon chain, whereas this one is carboxylate ion. That's why they are known as amphipathic. It has got both of them, a polar head as well as non-polar tail. So when they come together, all these polar heads will come together like this. They form like a monolayer. So what happens is, whenever an oil is there, it is surrounded with this non-polar tails. All these non-polar tails will surround them, whereas the heads are aqueous in nature. So this aqueous part will dissolve in water and they take away this oil part. This is how soaps will work. See, the oil droplet is emulsified by long chain carboxylate ion micelle. So all the soaps will act like this. Let me repeat this again. See, the long chain fatty acids are amphipathic in nature. They have a polar head and they have a non-polar tail is there. All of them will come together and form a structure known as micelles. So what they do is, whenever there is an oil molecules, oil globules are there, it is surrounded with non-polar tails and which has got a polar head. The polar head is soluble in water. So in the water, the oil molecules go out. They are washed away. This is how soaps will work. So this is the third process known as saponification. So these are all the three major chemical properties of triglycerides. Thank you for watching this video. If you like the video content, do subscribe.